Hello and welcome to the next video about controls. Today we're going to talk about on how we can distinguish between different control types. Okay, so there are different control types and we want to see what can be distinguished between. So we have a control. This control belongs to a certain control type. There are different complexibility. This most simple control system is the so-called pilot control. Pilot control. So if there is our control system somewhere, there is an input signal, and from this input signal, to whatever control law, this is the controller, the output signal is determined. So the output signal directly depends on the input signal. The input signal is piloting the output signal. Okay, this is why this is called. So from XI, we go directly to XO. This means if XI is not here, XO will also disappear. Okay? XI is always necessary for this type of controls. So they're just deforming or somehow determining what XO should be from XI. If XI is gone, nothing. That's the pilot control. Simplest control anyway. One possibility is, one example is, there's a button, you press the button, then there's light. You release the button, no light. Does not really make sense, okay? But that's how it is done. Pilot control. Other type of control is holding element control. Here, the controller of course also has some output. There is also some input. However, the input is just doing something inside the controller. The controller knows the input was already there. So the input might get the controller in a different state and the output is reacting on the internal state of the controller. Okay? And then maybe a second input will switch the controller to a second state and the output is again. So the controller is holding the information from the inputs. This is why holding element. It's stored in there somehow. So XO from internal holding element . This is already a little bit more complex control type. I need to at least store something inside. One example would be, there is a button, you press it, the light goes on. There's another button, you press it, the light goes off. In between, there is no input, but the output is still there. It's holded. Okay, and then the most complex things. This is program control. Red, program control. So now, our controller does not just interpret the inputs with some in a certain manner. It is following a program. There are even program controls out there which do not even need inputs. The so-called scheduled or timing control. So there is a scheduled or timed control. This controller sometimes to just have outputs. Controller several outputs and the output they are following at a program which is time controlled. So there is something going on there, and first this output for instance, then the after 30 seconds the second output, then the third output short, and then go back to the second. So there's a program, and the program progress is controlled just by time. This is it's scheduled. It's scheduled. The outputs are scheduled to a certain time. One example would be, for instance, traffic light. Traffic light, there is green, and so on. More sophisticated approaches of traffic lights, of course, have inputs reacting on if there is a need to switch and so on. However, base traffic lights are just time controlled, scheduled controlled. Okay. Then another possibility is travel control. This travel control, they do always have. Did they set an action? Yeah, something is moving, is traveling, in the control system, and then there is a limit switch somehow. This is indicating, okay, we have reached our destination, and this limit switch is then triggering the next output, so the next action, the next movement. Cylinders are often controlled that way, so that we are. If the cylinder goes out, it will touch a limit switch. The cylinder is out, so I can do the next step and press and whatever to use the next cylinder and so on, and then move back and travel controlled from the development of the program or the upload that follows the program sequence is triggered by limit switches because of traveling some actuator somewhere. Okay, that's travel control, part of program control. And there is of course then also the sequence control. The sequence controls, they are the more complicated things. They know exactly what they are. They are usually done in steps. So there's a first step. These and these action have to happen. Now it does not really matter if it's time scheduled or if it's travel control. The step has a defined ending. If this ending has been reached due whatever reason, we go to the next step, and the next step will then do something else, and then the next step and the next step. So this is a sequence. This is why it's sequence controlled. So these program controls, they do not just determine the outputs because of a pattern of input or something like this. They really know where they are, what they are doing and so on. This program now might either be hard-coded. It might be, there might be an electronic circuit simply. You cannot reprogram this. It's just the logic of this thing. We've done this in digital elements. We derived some logic there, and if we build this up, then it's doing exactly that logic. This is already a program in the means of control theory. Okay, program control. Or more sophisticated approach, of course, if we have a control type which can be reprogrammed even. So the program can either be fixed because my wires are going that way, or if it's an hydraulic or pneumatic control, because my my tubes, my hoses are connecting the certain valves in a certain way. So this has to be, this is what happens. Yeah? And if I want to reprogram it, I need a tool. Yeah? I need a screwdriver, I need some things to loose my tubes and reprogram the logic. Yeah? A more sophisticated way then is if the program is stored like in a computer. Yeah? It's a PLC, programmable logic controller, or a field programmable gate array, FPGA. These are things. Yeah? What's up behind these names? We will learn during this course. Yeah? So program does not necessarily mean, yeah, it's something on the computer. Yeah? It can be just some wires. So these are the different controller types. Pilot control, most simple, holding element control, stores already something, and then program control. They are really complex programs, yeah? Complex things can be done. They are either time controlled, they might be travel controlled, or they might be sequence controlled. Next time, we're going to look into deeper into the controller. Yeah? So these are the type controlling types, and next time we certainly look into the controller, how the controllers can be put into drawers, let's say. Yeah? They can be categorized. The controller itself, not the controlling strategy, the controller itself. Yeah? For this time, thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.